Hey, welcome to the Data Science with Kunal Naik show. Today we have with us Satyaki Casey, who is an ML developer at Posier, and he is exploring the world with AI data science and analytics. Also, he's a student of RCC IIT, which is an affiliated college to the West Bengal University. Welcome to the show, Satyaki.
Yeah, thanks, Kunal. Thanks for inviting me and looking forward to explore a lot of things. Just I'm exploring data science and AI. I hope I can explore a lot of things with you, can learn a lot from you in this session. So, yeah.
Absolutely. There is a lot to learn from you also, Satyaki. So, let's get started with this.
Yeah.
So, you're a final year student at, RCC IIT College.
Yeah.
And you have managed to get a full-time job.
Yeah.
Posier, right?
Yeah.
As an ML developer.
Yeah.
Now, how did you manage that? Can we get the story from the beginning?
Yeah, sure. So, I'm starting it from the very beginning. So, as we all been through that, the core pandemic phase, like I'm starting it from the beginning. It's still going on. It's still taking toll in our lives. I'm still thinking that we may need to do work from home rest of our life, which I am not at all happy doing it. But yeah, that time, in the corona period in March, April. So what happened is, as we are seeing the lockdowns are coming and I personally saw, okay, this is not going to be end and need to do something productive in it. So I was someone who is not at all into engineering and especially in coding. I am currently pursuing electronics engineering, which some relatives told me that you be in it, you will be in core and you will be in software, in between you will be there. Like then after 12 years, it's fine, electronics, I can be in both, any job, these things popped up, I then got into it. And in India, you have to do engineering, otherwise you're not this millionaire. Yeah.
Even I am the same person here, engineering you have to do.
Yeah. So this is how it started out, and then back in third year, I then found in the midst of the pandemic, I need to do something. So I have a little bit knowledge, just you may say basic syntax knowledge. I don't even know C properly, like what is programming, I don't like the essence of programming, but like people like to think in data structure, algorithmic way, in a technical way, logical way. I'm not at all that person. So then, in house, I was there. Okay, let's start it. So I again started my Python journey. I think it was in May, June. I started watching YouTube videos, practiced a bit of code in PyCharm. Then I found, this is not going to work. Python is not for me. I can't do Python all my life. Let's see what I can do in some functional parts where I can include some mathematics, some physics, because mathematics and physics, I think it goes better with me, although I score terrible in my boards and JE, but it's okay, it goes with me. I felt
you would like to call yourself more as an applied mathematics person rather than a academic mathematics person.
Right? Yes, true. That is what I am also currently doing. I am very much into applied analytics currently, I'll come into that thing. Then after searching, reading articles day by day, seeing blogs, I didn't know back then what was LinkedIn. Just heard from few people's mouth, okay, LinkedIn is such a platform, you will just get job, you will create account, you will get job in LinkedIn, or like it's kind of like a job portal, like we heard about Indeed, Monster, Glassdoor, and I was not looking at all for job back then. I started. Then I found out, I make some strategies, with learning Python, how it will going to help me. Then somehow I ended up, the first thing which I learned is the library Matplotlib. In YouTube, Cory Schaeffer's video. I think it's Schaeffer or Schaefer. Cory Schaeffer's video.
Schaeffer.
I think it has 10 to 11, videos.
Matplotlib.
I started with that because what I found, the coding part, because since I am from electronics background, I am a bit familiar with MATLAB, that MathWorks product. So the syntaxes are more or less same. And I was getting the concept back then in my college days, when in second year, third year, we just have to, I just mug up the code, somehow written in my hands. Okay, this will come, I will just, okay. Just don't know what is it. But then when in when I started with Matplotlib, I revisited that codes. Then it was starting making me sense, like the signals, frequencies, how Matplotlib is related with all these things. Then it started. I started it. Then I learned means I seen some videos in pandas. Okay. Code Scaffolds video only. And it was brilliant. That 10-11 blocks of videos, I still see them. They are so much beneficial. Like the basics of pandas and basics of Matplotlib, which you will know that these are the building blocks of analytics and machine learning.
Data science. Yes.
Yeah,
yes.
Yeah. Whatever advanced libraries come on pandas or seaborn plotly, people are telling about it. But if you know Matplotlib to the core, you are very much on with at least visualizing the data, like how to interpret it. So this is what I found. Then after seeing videos, I am not at all like to read articles. Okay. I am not into someone who can read articles.
All a visual guy. Even I am a more YouTuber guy.
Yeah. I am a YouTuber guy.
Find everything on YouTube.
Yeah. Whatever I feel problem, instead of Google, I first search for a video, whatever that may be. And yeah, except Stack Overflow, that we can't figure out in YouTube. This we have to go in Google. Apart from that, everything I search on YouTube. So I the guy is very popular and he's doing tremendous work. And I need to thank him personally someday. It's Krishnayak. You have heard him, obviously. I will say he's the man in data science. Because the kind of concepts which people are forecasting deep learning, machine learning in such a way, beginners can't even want to get it. Suppose someday you want to learn deep learning, but I found, okay, this is my personal experience. Don't this is the true audience. I'm telling you, this is not you take it for granted, but I found it's my personal.
But this
experience.
Is your experience. Yeah.
Enough. What I found, even in LinkedIn posts also, what I found, people give such deep learning or machine learning terms or they want to explain in such way. I'm not seeing all of them. Few of them I found, and also in articles in Google blogs. I didn't feel it because at the very first stage only, they are going into concepts like in deep learning, I'm telling, into back propagation at the very first end. Okay, you are not getting anything. Suppose they are telling into Adam optimizer. So they are telling into max pooling, 2D matrices. So a guy who has not, I think in most of the cases in Indian scenario, when they are engineering, apart from the a few gems, I will mention these words, and a few guys from IIT, we don't go into such technical parts in engineering. Also, this is from my personal experience. Okay, what I have done and what I have seen around me, apart from a few guys, we just have to few people are very good at coding. They go into comparative coding, machine learning, data science from the earlier age, even web development. Most of them are not in such technical way. Okay, we will just get into somehow day before or a week before exam. We will take the 10 years, 20 years, match the question. We will solve anything. This capability all engineering students have. So what I found both in LinkedIn and in Google, they are first giving, 1D matrix with such vectors will be fitted to our deep learning model. Who will understand what is 1D vector and matrix after so many years? We have left them in 11-12. I am telling in my experience. Okay. I found in Krishnak's video, he explained those concepts so well, so well. There are his playlists are all there in YouTube. I'm kind of promoting him without anything. You start. I also people now come to me a bit, 2 to 3 guys. Where should we start? Should I do this? I told them.
Start with Krishnak and Krishnak.
Yeah. A crash on Krishnak. He is uploading Python videos also. Back then, he didn't have Python in so much depth. I learned the OOPS concepts in Python, the functions from another channel called Code with Harry. Okay. Now I don't watch that channel so much because he is into core programming. He uploads regarding Java, C. I have stopped watching him, but he is brilliant in Python. His Python playlist is worth watching. But I felt in
Now you have all of these courses that you learned.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
And then now what you did, what was the next step
Yeah.
after you have started learning? What was the next step that you did?
Yeah, I want to mention another channel. Okay, I know
it. What is that?
Yeah, that is StatQuest. Yeah. StatQuest from
StatQuest. That yes,
is,
yes.
That is
Josh Tammer.
Yeah, man, he is a connection of mine also in LinkedIn. But I literally want to thank that guy also. I don't know whether this
he has
video
simplified everything.
Oh man, everything. But after watching his videos, I literally feel, man, I know maths. I love maths. This kind of thing. Like awesome.
Absolutely.
Krishnan's videos are more of a, it's functional type. He doesn't go into technical aspect of it, but you will get a great understanding. But if you want to start loving the subject,
it's like if you want to know what is there in the car bolts and all of that, you have to open up the whole entire pieces, then you have to go to
StatQuest, Josh Tammer. Awesome. And he is uploading, I have to watch them. He is uploading currently videos regarding deep learnings, like the neural networks and all. What I know the basics of deep learning are so in from basically from Krishnak's video, and I also followed some other channels. Now with time, I am like exploring different channels. I am getting familiar with it, but even 2 months back also, I'm not at all that much comfortable with all. It all like starts happening now, and also this job factor is giving me a confidence. Okay, I am in a professional line. I have got a responsibility. I need to do something, especially in a competitive atmosphere in a startup where I am working, where every single day is like expecting something from me to come up with something so that the company will grow. So these are my resources. So what I did actually, so one elder brother is there, like not my own brother. He is like a cousin brother. He is into IT field. He is currently in Accenture. He is in IT field 11, 12 years. I told him that, I am doing it. Then he took me a interview kind of thing. I didn't recognize back then he was taking me interview. And after that, after half an hour, he told, man, you go to it. You will get something. Sure. And then he told me, you open a LinkedIn. He told me, he showed me his profile. Okay, this is LinkedIn. I then asked. I was like, LinkedIn? I don't know nothing. There would be so much people and LinkedIn is just for job. Well, he just told that you just open a LinkedIn account. Start seeing it, observing what people are doing. You will get the idea. I know you. I just then told you, okay, that is in month of September. Okay, September end. Then in the October month, we have Navratri and all. And I didn't get into so much into after Navratri period and before Lakshmi Puja, I opened LinkedIn account. In the end of October, I opened LinkedIn account. Then initially, I didn't know anything. Okay, then I start figuring out people. I asked him, I almost regularly consulting, okay, what should I do? Then I got a connection, the first good connection which I got, I'm still in touch with that guy. Not so much, but yeah, that is Aditya Shelke. Okay. Back then, I was looking a position as a sports analyst because I was getting familiar with analyst part and I have a love for sports. Like I am a sports guy kind of thing. If this pandemic even not happened, I may be in a sports field because I thought I will change my engineering career. I may take either sports management or some line in sports. But this pandemic.
Now you're doing sports analytics.
Kind of this. I then told him, I want to do in a sports analyst thing. And he is now in a startup. Not a startup, he's in a club as a sports analyst. He told me back then, you stay with me and we will make something. Then I work with him in a kind of project. We thought we will put into some ISL clubs. He is from Goa. This time ISL is happening in Goa. We thought we will get into it. Then I found sports analytics is not attracting me. There are two reasons. One, I didn't know. I maybe lost interest in sports suddenly because what I found, I don't know. It's my experience. Nowadays, sports is much into business area. Everything is being focused in such a way the passion for sports is losing. Like the club's top goal is like not how to finish first. How many fan jerseys you can sell? How many social media reactions you can get? This is my experience. Across the globe, I am seeing. So, this is the one factor I failed. Another thing which I failed, in India, there is no concrete base for sports field. Apart from players, you can't do a alternative way to reach to a like a sports club or a sports analyst. I talked with sports people, I connected with them. This is the learning journey from me. I learned, okay, how to connect, how to leverage myself to people, how to know them. And what
and all this through LinkedIn.
All this through LinkedIn. This is the problem. Like this is when I started getting, okay, LinkedIn can do so much to you. And what what like triggers me more to stay at LinkedIn, to stay consistent, to do at least something creative with LinkedIn is like overwhelming responses from the people. Like most people were well settled. I was then back then I was doing nothing. 3-4 months. I was like thinking, okay, what to do, what not to do. Like then people helped me like nothing. Most of them, like they contacted me. I contacted them. I asked them stupid questions. They like told me, man, you can contact me like anything, anytime. Then I, then it happened in this way. Then when I was at the back end, you can say I was continuously learning. This is the one thing I want to say everyone. Like we, what I felt is we don't need to do like 10, 12 hours of thing. Okay. Like, or we don't need to, first only we need, don't need to go to and look a lecture of MIT. You start with maybe a C program, but you do it consistently, at least for a few period of time.
This it's like be driven, not, you know, come and hit sixes and fours every time.
Yeah. Be consistent. Like
if you want to do it daily, if you want to learn, do it daily. That is
what I am feeling. That because in between many things happened, as like what I will say, but like I am not a guy. Yeah, this is the thing for me. I even 1 week back also I messaged a startup guy. Okay, like randomly that bhaiya, I got into a job, but now I am feeling a bit confused. What like. I also want to do marketing and sales. I want to produce contents like this kind of thing I told, but I am loving ML and I am loving my job kind of thing and the people around me, the vision for them. I told him, then he strictly told me, you can't do everything in the world
at one time.
You can't do it's not possible. You forget about marketing. He just told me in this way, tum ab marketing sales ke bare mein bhool jao, wo kabhi kar lena. He just told me that word, kabhi kar lena. You focus on ML and be best at it. Then on that, this is just 1 week back. How like this is how I am. Like I am not at all this is the thing for me. Like
so you're constantly exploring. That's why you're telling you're exploring the world of AI.
Yeah.
But not only the world of AI, but other fields also you're trying to explore.
Yeah. I have put also content creation. I have put into it, but I have now removed two days back because that is adding a pressure to me. Because when I am putting, because now I use my LinkedIn about and header as my goal statement. Not like for me, I visit my LinkedIn profile like people visit their to-do list. I visit it. Okay, this is I have to do. And
remind you that you are going to do this for some time, right?
Yeah. I think you, when you first contacted me, there was a like pipe I've given me, the content creation I have put into it. I removed it because it's creating a burden for me. Like, okay, I have to create content. I have to do because I just at the beginning, before the things were starting, I told I want to do some content related thing. But I am not currently delving myself into it because I want to this field, this AI field is like kind of getting me, and also the market is there for AI. This is also a good factor. If the market was dying, I may not be into that phase. And also one factor, the current company which I am doing, the vision, the founder, which I am talking about, and they are also providing me with a lot of confidence. I am loving how they interact, how they work. So it's all summing up like, yeah, I am into AI now. I am exploring it. So yeah, now I will like to share how I got
it. It's not the end of the world, Satya ki. You'll do this for some couple of years, maybe something else. You have a lot of time with you.
Yeah.
Okay. So now basically you learned daily. You started reaching out on LinkedIn.
Yeah.
But there is one thing that you particularly do very nice is writing posts.
Yeah.
Right. And that's, I believe, something that helped you get your first job, right?
Yeah.
So how, like, for example, you've told me that, you know, you are doing, let's say 1 month. How many months of posts have you done so far? And, within how much time you got that job of that?
I was posting a few snippets of code. Like, I used to train basic ML models, taking a random forest regressor classifier or like linear logistic regression. I took up the 100 days coding challenge. Okay. And then I started posting. Like, whatever I was doing, I was not. One thing, I'm being true to myself, and I want to like to know everyone. The codes were too simple. Like, I was training from I was taking linear regression from the Sklearn library. I'm not writing it from scratch so that I can forecast it. But what I was doing, I was not copying it. I was typing in my hand. And what I found right now is, if you type the code, okay, like even if you write import numpy as np, and if you copy the import numpy as np and put it there, what I felt, it makes a huge difference. If you type the code, it adds up to you, like in your back end of your head.
It's like muscle memory. Like, you can now type any code very simply without recalling or copying, and you're faster with the code.
Absolutely, absolutely. At the very beginning of this podcast, I told I'm not at all into coding and all. But just by putting some Stack Overflow codes which are a bit tricky to understand, I put them, I understand, that's okay. Because that's only one time use. But things, the libraries which we ML people need, like Sklearn, UC Matplotlib, Pandas, NumPy, I like to write it. Even I may see it, I may forgot it, I will see it at Google, I will type it, I will not copy and paste. This is one thing also I also like to tell. It really helps a lot. So what I was doing back then, I took up the 100 days ML challenge, like data science challenge. By that is also I learned from through LinkedIn posts. Okay, how to interact with LinkedIn, how people are posting. I saw
few... So you got that 100 days challenge and you thought, okay, let me do it.
Yeah. But I didn't finish. I didn't finish it. There were two reasons for that. One was like, I did for 9 or 10 days consistently. There was one reason. I been to the one vacation in the month of December. I thought I will post there. I will like what I know. I will like post some basic contents or stuffs or blogs kind of thing. But I didn't felt, okay, no, I can't do this. This 100 days ML challenge will not go for me. Then I come back from vacation. Then I felt, okay, I can, this is something which came from within. Okay. Okay. Let's learn. Let's post something, some algorithms. Let's see how it reached. Before that, it like my like posts were 2, 3, 4 reactions or one comment hardly. Like I thought that this is not going to be like, I like realized this is not, because I am not putting that thing which will add value to the people. One thing, there is a guy, I'm mentioning his name. That is Hariharan. His name is. He's a great guy. Okay. He provides me the confidence. He told me one thing, I just remember. Like, you post contents in LinkedIn that you are helping someone to learn through your post. However simple it is. Like, it's maybe one line of code. Suppose, like, import Sklearn, import linear regression, import NumPy as np. Like, you learn what is NumPy or what is Pandas. Pandas is used for data analysis purpose. Yeah, someone will learn something. Okay, Pandas mean data analysis. NumPy means an array or matlib thing. You are learning someone. Not do this NumPy. Pandas. Not post.
This so basically is... all posts which are like geared towards helping other people. That's why you made the shift from 10 days. Instead of continuing that journey, you shifted to add value to the audience.
Absolutely.
Versus just writing randomly.
Absolutely. Absolutely. What I like, it may be wrong. I have to take feedbacks from like, seniors like you and other people. I feel like I love to teach. Maybe it's as basic, like I love to talk, I love to communicate. So I thought, and then I was also reading people talking a lot about storytelling. This stuff were going on in LinkedIn. And I didn't search. I didn't know that thing what is storytelling was back in December. I then found, okay, storytelling is something like this. You interact with people, this, that. And then there is one sir, I will say, Samir something Kochhari, or like, he's very popular nowadays in like he also got popular. He also built his business blueminds.com through LinkedIn only, just by posting random stories. Then it hit me, okay, I know the match behind it. I just know, don't I am not someone like
now you're introducing maths to storytelling also.
Yeah. This is what I am focusing on right now also. How to improve myself in technical aspect, like to put more technical content in 3 to 4 or 5 lines through a LinkedIn post. This is my current, like you can say, aim I have taken. I don't know in how many days I will. I am not posting randomly some stuff. I am thinking in that way. Okay, how can I bring some technical aspects into my post so that people will get benefited for sure. And I will also feel a good factor about my post. That is also important. If you don't love your posts, whatever little content it is, I think people will not value you. There is some people says, like, if you don't value yourself, why other people will value you?
So you shifted from doing random content to basically providing value to this thing. And how many of this value added post you might have posted roughly?
I think it may be 40 above.
40. Yeah. And you started in December or so.
December,
like that, right?
December. Yeah. Around December.
Okay. So from December to maybe Jan, right?
Yeah.
You have written these many posts. And so what happened then? Like how you got contacted from Posier after writing all of these posts?
Yeah. So I still have my 2 semesters left in my college. So I was not looking for job then. Okay. I was loving to post. I was feeling good. Like, yeah, I'm learning a lot of stuff. I then saw the huge horizon, like what ML, AI and data science is actually. Because there are tons and tons of people doing posts, this, that, etc. Previously, when I was not in LinkedIn, I was just getting a narrow vision. LinkedIn just widened off my vision. Okay, so many things can be done in a creative way, this, that. I was not looking for jobs back then. What happened, what triggered me is, in my college, campusing happened. Okay, I didn't took part in my campusing. 2 reasons. One, I underestimated my college. I thought they can't provide jobs. I have to figure out something of my own. And second, what I in corona period, when I was into a self-reflecting zone, I found, okay, I can't be in an MNC in a system engineer role or a junior developer role. I can't. Because first thing is, like, I thought college can't provide anything. But then in December, what I found, like, apart from 2 to 3 guys in my group, all have got job, all have like got one job, and this was like a crunch point for me. Like, man, dude, they got job, and I am studying ML, they got job. Like, this kind of feelings triggered
this
in
comparison.
Me.
Yeah, you started comparing yourself with
your peers. Back then, I wasn't that active at WhatsApp. Now for job purpose, I have to be active in WhatsApp to keep contact with them. I am not like, I don't use social media at all. Like LinkedIn, I use that also in limit. Okay. And I'm very much less active in WhatsApp. So I didn't read the campusing contents, like my peers and CRs are posting in our group. I've heard later on all of my friends, like,
I have gotten job
and, like, I know, like, they are only my kind of nine. Yeah, they know simpler stuff. They don't know into ML. And they asked me, okay, why are you not sitting in campusing? I just, in a sweet swag, no, I don't require it. I am okay. I haven't told them in ML and data science I was learning it because I wasn't confident back then. Okay, I thought, okay, this won't work. I may lose interest. I am that kind of guy. So when I found they got job, that hit me. Okay, no, I have to now do something. This kind of thing. Then I started seeing how to back, like, this is a problem. This is a huge problem for me. Like, all the people, I will say successful people says, whatever you have, you be first. You don't compare yourself at all with people. But I don't know how my mind is typically wired. How whatever I do, I simply love to do. I put my, not I'll say 100%, I try to put. Yeah, I am doing it. But still my mind shifts to comparison with other people. And still my mind will figure out, okay, this guy is higher than you. He has more followers. He will get
it
more.
It is the human brain. It is designed to be comparing yourself. Even today I compare myself. I have to every time think again. Okay, don't compare. Absolutely. So you figured out not to compare with anybody.
Yeah, I just told myself in a hard way. There were 2 campusing interviews that are also pending. Okay, like pending means that apti round was pending. I haven't enrolled for previous 2 and they were telling me to enroll. So I filled up the form. I thought, okay, I need to get a job also. Beside ML, I used to study ML at the morning, practice few steps, visiting the old algorithm, visiting my old codes, thinking of, okay, what thing I can like, what code I can do, or and then I started also Apti, because that insecurity seeped into me. Okay, I have to get a job. For 3 to 4 to 5 days, I have done it. Then I figured out, okay, Apti will be there. Let's post, like, search for jobs at LinkedIn. Okay. So one thing also, I am very much into startups. Very much into startups mean, in this whole period, what I kind of, in AI ML, I kind of do a, you may say, a reverse engineering. I first figured out the business problem. Then I prepared myself. This point I missed. I from YouTube videos, especially one guy, Ranveer Alabadi, I think his title. Ranveer is the name. He has a podcast, The Ranveer Show. Okay. I used to look into his posts and he's awesome. Like, I will say many key factors of me, like, is being developed by him. Beer biceps. Exactly. It's true. That guy. Then I heard about he has some podcast related to LinkedIn and all. Then I heard, like, from people who are entrepreneurs or who are, you may say, like, working in, like, head positions in a startup or corporate, they told, if you want to be in a startup, you prepare yourself so that you can be useful to them, to the startup, so that you may hire you. I prepared my profile also. I prepared my mindset. First, I prepared my mindset. And my LinkedIn profile, I honestly say, it's currently a reflection of my mindset. What I am thinking now.
That's how you made change your title to be focused on AI and ML. Otherwise, it was content creation. And then you came back to this particular title.
Actually, whatever my mindset is, and I have promised myself, I'm telling you, we may say publicly, I will not change my header and my about section, at least for quite a few time. I'll not change. Because whatever, like, I have told you, some thoughts come, I again come into my LinkedIn profile, I change it. I won't do it. I want to stick to it. So yeah, back to the main topic. So then I kind of figured out, okay, how to prepare myself for startup. 5 to 6 months back, me working at a startup was a dream. Even 2 months back, the position I am in currently, like, the main, the responsibility. I was telling to my friend, the founder of the company is talking with me, is consulting with me, ki Satya ki, what to do? You come up with solution. This is I was imagining, literally, this was a kind of like a dream for me. Okay, I will talk with founders in real life. I will try my best to solve problems. I will not limit myself like an MNC part of thing. Okay, you do this, you will, at the end of the month, you will get this done. What I feel like, I want to create kind of thing. Maybe I'm wrong. Maybe I'll fail 1,000 times, but I'll have to create what nobody has done. Learning from people, that, like, my antennas are always on. And implementing in my own way, that boosts me, and everything comes later on. This is why I like love startup. Even the founder also told me that I found through your profile and through your conversation, you are into startups, and that's why I'm hiring you. So you may say they took me more of my AI ML skill than my love for startups or my passion for startups.
So basically, they got the mindset. They understood through your profile. They understood what you are, who you are, what you value, what you like, and what exactly can you bring value to the company itself. You want to be there in that place.
The position I am currently in. See, one thing is, I am also telling it, I am not that, like, I am not a work from home kind of guy. Okay. Like, I want to interact with people. I want to interact with the stakeholders. What are the current situations? I sometimes even ask them. He's like, sir, am I crossing the boundary? He says, no, you ask me anything. Then I ask some business details. Like, I know I'm crossing my limits, because it's not been a month. I want to know their business. And just 2 days back, he told me a thing. I'm telling it, like, Satyaki, see, you are the part of the business. You may consider it's your business. You give your best. We are with you. You see it, posture. It's your business. You are a part of it. So this gives me a boost, kind of. Yeah, man, this is what I want. Like, this came from within. More of
so a, everything aligned. So whatever you had in your mind is manifesting in real.
Yeah, yeah. You can say. I am still like people in my, like, you may say locality or like or my relatives. It's a kind of shock for them. Why shock? Not for the job. Because like, I used to tell these stuff. Yeah, I mean, to do startup, this, that. When I'm telling them, I personally don't even, am I into reality? Am I into like, what is this? I want to be a startup.
You can't believe you are there.
I still today, it's almost being a month, I still can't believe that I am in a startup working as an ML developer, what I aspired for, and taking a few decisions and learning a hell lot amount of things. So yeah, so this is a kind of my excitement, you can see, mugging into
it is definitely visible. So yeah. So basically, so the Posture founder reached out to you because you built the profile in such a way, and you told the LinkedIn profile, LinkedIn members, that hey, this is what I am and this is how it, what it is, right?
Yeah.
And so now you know the surprising thing for me is you don't even need so many followers to you know, get a job, right?
Yeah.
You know, generally people think that, okay, I need so many followers before some traction will happen. But if you design your profile very well, it will get the job done.
Yeah.
Am I right?
Yeah, Sataki? Yeah, yeah. Back then when I got the job, I don't even have 500 connections. Okay. I have 480, yeah, 470 connections and less than 50 followers. This is added up after my after I got job, because after that also I keep posting. And I keep, I post regularly.
You will continue to post whatever it is. Right?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I love to post. I love to write. Like, currently, since I'm in ML, thoughts and my ideations are in ML field. But I am very much into writing. I write a few basic stuffs for me regularly. And I also put it in my about section. Like, 2 days back also, it was visible that I want to write. Like, apart from ML, I want to write. But now I have removed. I've kept it short, crisp. And this is my own way.
So let's look at some of the posts you have, Sataki.
Yeah, and, yeah, sure.
You know, because you know, this will give an idea to the audience what kind of posts work. So let's see all activity, and I'm going to go to the post section of your profile.
Yeah.
Okay. So let's say we have 38 likes, 10 comments, right? Let's see.
These are the jobs which I've shared.
Correct. Okay. So then we have 17. You have 37, 8 comments. This is K nearest neighbors, right?
Yeah.
So you're consistently posting about, see, hyperparameter tuning.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
So roughly 30 to 10, 30 likes, 10 comments you're getting almost from these this profile, right?
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Okay. So, like, how do you get these article ideas, and what do you write? Like, so for example, let's take this one, right? It got 73 likes.
Yeah.
And this one. So how do you take this? How did you end up writing this one?
So I was working, like, I'm telling it, in my company currently, we are working on a, like you may say, a time series model. So I was studying into it, the time series analysis models. Before that, I don't know. Like, before joining the job, I didn't explore at all the time series is such a huge dimension. It's a huge part of machine learning. I was into like more into the statistical algorithms, linear, logistic, the CART algorithms, and the few deep learning like ANN and like this kind of stuff I was into. When I got into it, the current thing we are working on needs time series models. Yes, so I started learning time series.
What does the business predict? If you can share some, just an idea.
Yeah, see, the time series analytics are more into, it predicts, it is a kind of forecasting model. Time series analytics does, what it does is, it takes all the past data, with date as a parameter, and forecasting, like suppose we may take sales forecasting. Okay. Like 2010 to 15, you put the date, maybe in month, day, or even hour basis, or in years, you may take 50, 60 odd years, and our model will search, it will take the dates and the parameters into factor, it will start predicting it. And we may and all
in your at Posier. So what were you trying to predict?
Yeah, we were working on a forecasting model. Mm-hmm. So I have to go deep into to like see we have all the algorithms ready in S, it was stat models, we have all the algorithms ready in there, but this is every ML people say, and this is what I am also learning. The ML algorithms will do the job, they will do the calculations for you, but you have to know the, like, suppose I am taking it, suppose there is moving average, exponential smoothing. Mm-hmm. What is moving average? What is the formula? Because mm-hmm. When you train a model just by calling it from the Python library, it will do its mm-hmm. own job. But the real mm-hmm. trick lies in hyperparameter tuning. If you mm-hmm. don't understand such as like concepts like exponential smoothing or a very mm-hmm. common concept in a time series model that is stationary data, seasonality, mm-hmm. trend, how to adjust them mm-hmm. so that your model will start giving actual good predictions over unseen mm-hmm. data. You have mm-hmm. to know this in details. So I started mm-hmm. learning it through YouTube and through a few, this thing, as I mentioned, I am into video person. This a few mm-hmm. things YouTube don't have such good contents in time series analytics. So I am telling any people who are into time series analytics model, you may have your own contents ready and push into YouTube. People will see, because what I found, this is my research, because for the past few weeks I am into time series and I haven't found any. Yeah, this is the playlist which you can help learn anything and everything. There are a few books of O'Reilly, which I started reading, then I lost interest because it was so much details were there. I lost my concentration. I again stopped them and I came back.
Maybe offline, if you can give me some topics, Satyaki, we can talk. We can talk and we develop something. Why not?
Yeah. Sure. So this is the part of this post of.
So basically, you whatever you're discovering or learning in the job, you try to put and summarize this, and that's why it's basically you took all of that whatever you learned and summarized it in such a way that it is consumable, right? So basically, yeah, you took everything from what you're doing at your job,
yeah,
and then summarized it so that it can help others figure out the same things that you are learning.
Yeah,
right.
Yeah.
And so this is your objective. And how much time do you take to write a post, something like this, post
see,
it?
What approach I am following, it has evolved with a period of time. Now what I am doing, whatever I am learning, what I am doing throughout the day, okay, it's just I have my dinner, I come, I take my phone, and I then recall, okay, this is what I learned. I then post, and it hardly takes for me 5 to 6 minutes.
So basically, this is your journal, reflection journal.
Yeah.
You come and write it, and it's done.
So that
itself is enough. Right? Yeah, so whatever you learned, summarize it and write it on LinkedIn. As simple as that.
Yeah. This is what I do.
Awesome. Yeah. So thanks for sharing this, Satyaki. This was awesome. So basically, let's say in summary, be consistent in learning, right? You're a visual guy. If you're a visual guy, use YouTube. You have Shoffer, you have Krishnak, you have StatQuest, you have Code with Harry.
Yeah.
And then not only that, then you also have, what are the other places you were learning, you told Satyaki?
Yeah. These four are the principal part. Now I pick like content from everything. I learn from every channel, but these four
is the basics to get you started. So if you want to get started enough to crack a job like how Satyaki did it, these channels are sufficient enough to get you started, right? And then obviously one other skill that you need is to be able to write and on LinkedIn, have a LinkedIn profile, make a basic, show your mindset on your LinkedIn profile. Like Satyaki showed startups, he showed AI and ML, and he also showed his writing skills, right? He is able to write, and that is one important part of communication.
Yeah.
And so with all of these aspects, Satyaki, you are able to land the job at Posier.
Yeah.
And the way it manifested that the company founders or the CEOs itself contacted and talked to you and got took you into the job.
And
so now you are. So what's next right now? You have told about us, right? So basically, now next is you continue in this domain for a certain time, and also you mentioned one thing. You are now stepping into Kaggle, right? Like you declared one post saying that, okay, now I'm entering into podcast. So how do you plan to tackle podcast?
Kaggle.
How do you plan to tackle Kaggle?
Yeah, so what is currently, since we are in startup currently, we don't have 20, 50, 30, 60 or unlimited number of projects in our pipeline. We have one single job that we need to do in a like, in a best manner possible. So since it's a startup, we don't have like enough people currently. We have limited amount of people. So when I interact with seniors, there are a few mistakes which I do or some suggestions we need to take. Suppose I contact with the CTO. He has his own stuff. He's busy in it. I then send, I am stuck into it, or this is what I have done. Can you verify it, or can you say how it can be optimized? So this sometime I figured this takes, maybe it take up to a day. For 24 hours, there will be no response from them. Previously, when in the first week, I thought, see, they're not responding. They will throw me away. What is happening? This is not real. This is what, then I figured out, I talked with them. This happened in startup, because one man handling 10 man's job. This is what startup is. It boosts you to learn a lot of things.
And you shouldn't never take anything for personal, because you know in startup everybody is doing multiple things. You have to just continuously follow up, just like how LinkedIn. You have to write.
Yeah,
follow up.
Yeah. And then also, since I was not so much familiar with my founder, he then told, this is our requirement, you do it. And I didn't thought of, okay, how can I put, should I put my own ideas or thoughts, should they will consider it. Then he gave me a kind of blank check. Satyak, you think, you just need to think and implement, this is up to you. And then I felt a burst into it. And really what I am seeing is Kaggle can seriously create your base. One thing which Kaggle misses, which is, I will say, which is the 80% of the job, which is not at all in Kaggle, that is the data part. Kaggle has all the data set ready in them. Okay. But in real life, collecting data is the main part. But what I am going into Kaggle now, but I am delving myself into Kaggle, I am not into data science job. I don't have to collect data. That there are other people who collect data for me. I just have to tell my requirements, like, see, I am going to implement, I am going to solve this problem, I am going to build this model, I need this kind of data. And there are people who scrape data or who collect data
so
for me.
They are the data engineering team or there whatever is. It is.
There. Yeah.
And so you take that raw data dump and then you massage and create features.
Models. The burden of collecting data, I will say that is the main burden. When we figure out the business problem, if we can't get the proper data to like align with it, our project will fail. But my job is to like the later part, data will come. If I found a proper problem, if I found a proper itch, which is going to get solved, my job will be done. So this is where Kaggle comes. Kaggle gives you a tons and tons of how one problem can be solved in 1,000 ways. Maybe suppose I am taking example of time series. Okay. Maybe I'm solving a sales forecasting model. Kaggle has 20 different problems of 20 different minds, how they solved it. You don't have to replicate that 20 only, but for sure that 20 will give you a perspective how a forecasting model works, and that helps. And this is why I am in Kaggle. Previously, when I started in Kaggle, even 2 to 3 days, my mindset was, okay, I have to get medals, I have to get this. Then I settled myself, calm myself down. Look, I am not going to be a Kaggler. Okay, I am in my job and I am okay with it. I am very much happy about it. I want to learn from Kaggle so that I can learn something from it and implement in the real world. So I again, as I told, I changed my mindset. Now I am learning into Kaggles. I may sometimes promote my notebooks in Kaggle just for posting or like keeping in touch with LinkedIn people. There are many Kaggle people who are there in my connections. They interact, we interact, and I can learn a lot from them. like Kaggle people are awesome. Like they are very much into data science and all. So
absolutely. So that was a wonderful, powerful, and very exciting journey to listen from you, Satyaki.
Thanks.
I hope the audience is getting a lot from this, and I want to give this message that hey, if you learn consistently and preach or write on LinkedIn and have show your mind case there, you can definitely land a job. And just like Satyaki, who got the job even before finishing his fourth year, going away from his peer group who are attending placement cell jobs there, and he was the one, maybe one of the person right in your college that did this, or are there others?
I think I'm the only one. I don't know about the rest. So yes.
Absolutely. So that's there. And I thoroughly enjoyed talking to you, Satyaki, and capturing your journey.
Thanks a lot.
And thank you for doing this. And hopefully on time series, maybe next time when you get some more experience, we'll take few lessons from you on how to build time series models. What do you say?
Yeah, sure. I am, as I told you, I may come up, I don't know about podcasts and all. You are, as you told, you are very much into content creation, and I'm looking forward to a hell lot of things, how to actually create contents in daily life. I am like waiting for it, how to learn of
absolutely,
content.
Absolutely. So do work with me on, do follow my podcast on there. I'm talking to content creators from different parts of journey. How they are creating passive income, where they are getting ideas. It's called the Adjective Content Creators Podcast. I'm also making a YouTube channel where I'm teaching how to edit podcasts, how to do audio quality, how to start your podcast. So all of these processes is coming on that particular YouTube channel.
I'm sure I'm following it.
Yes, definitely. So thanks for that. And you do let me know on time series and on content creation, what are the problems you're facing, and we'll work together and have sessions like this to figure out stuff and do some great stuff.
Sure. That will be great. Yeah.